Hi everyone, it's John.
And Ben.
And it must be Halloween. We're doing all sorts of spooky toys and stuff this season, aren't we?
Yes.
And what's your favorite line of spooky toys?
Monster High.
Who do we have today?
Today, we have the CATTY NOIR.
We've had a lot of requests for CATTY NOIR. She just came out.
And we've heard stories of people trying to find her and having a hard time.
It looks like she signed the package. I wanted to see what it says.
Thanks for being a fan.
So she must be like a rock star in the Monsters University world.
It would look like it. It's pretty cool in her hand. You'll see it when it's out of the package, but in her hand, she has the microphone.
On the back, we have CATTY NOIR to leave stage on
high school note.
And it looks like a newspaper headline on the back.
Yep. Sorry, I was reading it, so. So, the back of this package, CATTY is giving up on the charmed life of a pop star to become just a regular ghoul at high school.
And she's the 16-year-old daughter of a Werecat.
So, that's pretty cool.
This doll is, the packaging and the doll itself are very eye-catching on the shelf. These jump right off at you.
Yes, you will not miss this on the shelf at all. Stands right out.
Even I remembered Ben owned this one. Usually we go down the Monsters High aisle and I go, and I can't remember which one she has. But this one, I remember that she had one of these.
Yep.
So let's crack this one open. Whoa!
I'm so excited. See, her stand is a little different. Isn't that cool?
Yep, shaped like the logo, the skull on the logo. Mm-hmm. Her stand part is clear.
Yep. I have a couple that are clear, but I don't know. We're going to need those instructions because I don't really know how you're supposed to put her on there. Oh, so she sits on it. Let's break her free. Well, look at this dress. That's just crazy. It's going to take me a little while, guys. Bear with me.
I'm going to go out and make a sandwich and take a nap.
Very funny. So to make her look appealing, they have all these little doodads holding her dress in place. So you have to find all of the little plastic pieces so that you don't rip her dress. So her boots are so crazy that they actually come apart.
And you snap them together.
Yeah.
It's actually pretty neat.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty neat idea. I like that idea better than the Equestria girls where you have to just rip their whole foot off, basically.
Yeah.
And they're just nubs underneath.
I don't think she's really designed to come out. She's more like one of those that you're supposed to keep in the box. Told you it was going to take me a little while. She is held in here very well.
Definitely need a steady hand. Toy reviewing doesn't work out for you, Ben. You could go into, like, brain surgery after this.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I think you have to go through a lot of schooling for that.
No, you just say, I've been opening up Monster High dolls for a year. Like, oh, you're in. Here's your degree.
No.
Now her crazy dress.
Now her crazy dress.
15 minutes later.
Yep. You're almost free. Now where am I attached? So, here she is. Look at that crazy dress that she's wearing.
We can't see it. There it is.
Oh, hold on. I'm unknotting it at the moment. Now, she is very pretty. She has, like, elastics everywhere. It's crazy.
Don't forget to put her shoes back on.
Yeah. So, I'll put her shoes back on here. Looks like you have to have them on the correct foot.
She comes with this stand that's a lot smaller than the normal Monster High stand. That's because she, like, sits, like, perched on it.
Mm-hmm. So she has this microphone that you put in between her fingers like that. She holds on to that. like she's singing. And then let's see how this stand works.
Actually looks like it works really good.
Yeah, and there she is.
You'd even display her like with a leg up or...
Mm-hmm. You could have her doing like a jump or something. Woo-hoo. That's pretty cool.
Now her insert is like her diary. There's like some music that she's written in there. And we also got the standard Monster High comb.
She is awesome.
Very well done. Nice collector fashion doll.
Mm-hmm. She is. She's amazing.
She would look great in the package, or if you just want to open it up and play with it.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. I think she looks good either way. The package was done very, very well.
Between Monster High and Ever After High, I think Mattel wins the fashion doll easily.
Definitely. Definitely. They are number one.
Equestria Girls, we love the characters, but the doll... And the dolls aren't bad, but...
No.
They don't hold a candle to...
No.
To these ones. Just our opinion.
But they have been making Barbie forever, so they should be good at it.
Oh yeah, Mattel does Barbie.
Yeah. But this is an awesome doll. I cannot wait to have her up on my shelf with the rest of them displayed for Halloween.
And speaking of Halloween, don't forget to go through all our older videos. Mm-hmm. We have a whole playlist of just this year's Halloween videos.
Yep.
So you can watch all our Halloween reviews of toys and candy and all sorts of other fun stuff.
And we have a playlist just for Monster High.
So be sure to subscribe to our channel so you won't miss any of our videos ever.
That's right.
You'll want to subscribe.
That's right.
And if you're already subscribed, you're cool.
And don't forget to like and comment on our videos.
Don't forget to follow us on Instagram.
On Twitter.
And on Facebook. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Bye. And we have a playlist just for Monster High.
Yep.
Yep.